हेलो गाइस, व्हाट्स अप। सो हियर वी आर विद आवर न्यू वीडियो ऑन मेटलर्जिकल इंजीनियरिंग जॉब। सो होपफुली मेनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर गोइंग टू पास आउट दिस ईयर एंड मेनी हैव गिवन द गेट एग्जाम। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। वी गॉट मेनी ईमेल्स फ्रॉम योर साइड। दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिमांडिंग वीडियो। व्हाट आर द करियर ऑप्शन आफ्टर बीटेक और बी इन मेटलर्जिकल इंजीनियरिंग? So for latest job updates, you can follow us on LinkedIn. Here is our metallurgical engineering page, where we put around 10 to 12 post vacancies daily. You can apply them. And we have our metallurgical engineering Facebook page, and on Instagram also we have came. So you can find us there, with many interesting videos of research and events. And you can visit our website studymeta.com, where you can easily find the GATE related content specifically and many books related to your engineering. So let us start. What are the career options? We have divided these options into three categories. Initially, first is direct job after BTech exam. Maybe you got a placement without GATE, or you can directly apply to their companies by sending your CV. And another is a GATE exam, from which you can get qualifying the GATE. You can go through the PSUs, government PSUs, and MTech you can do from IITs and NITs, and direct PhD also from PMRF scheme, that is Pradhan Mantri Research Fellowship scheme. You can go through that, and after that you can pursue PhD or postdoctorate for going for further academic line, like assistant professor or professor in good IITs and NITs. Further, for abroad, you can go for masters. You can go for a job, and after that you can go for PhD. We will see how can you apply for PhD in abroad in India a little briefly. So after that, let's see some of the direct job you can apply by interview. They generally, these are the companies which pursue the interviews, take out the vacancies. You can find the vacancies on their websites and the career options related to steel, like Tata Steel or Jindal Steel, and some heat treatment industries, metal working industries, and non-ferrous industries like Balco, and as well as non-ferrous generally work on nickel, cobalt. If you have their interest, you can apply there. And there are some of the direct job government organization where you have to only conduct a written exam or interview, not require GATE exam, like RINL, BARC, ISRO, BIS, NMDC, DRDO, and Ordnance Factory. What after qualifying GATE? This was the major question, whether we should go for a job or whether we should go for academic. It's on your interest. If you want to go for academic line or PhD research, go for PhD or go for MTech. Or if you have a good score, want to pursue for job, you can go for several PSUs. It required GATE score above 600, and after that you have to go through interview. And these are some of the list of the PSUs: RINL, BARC, BIS, DRDO, IOCL, BHEL, and SAIL. Further, GATE qualified higher education, many institute are there in India. Specifically, all the institute in government accept the GATE score for MTech admission, as well as you can also avail the fellowship, or that is scholarship of around currently it is 12,400, and currently here in India there are 23 IITs and ISCs and 31 NITs where you can pursue your masters in metallurgical engineering, masters in metallurgy, materials engineering, corrosion and polymers, and many other branches. Rubber engineering, there are many scope according to your interest you can explore. After that, get qualified. Suppose you have qualified the GATE, what next? You have got good score in GATE. You can go for IITs, NITs, for masters. If we have just qualified also, There is a high chance that you can go to at least in NITs. Just wait until the last counseling date. And from NIT IITs, you can go for placement. We will see several companies that visit the campus for placement, specifically in IITs and IITs. And you can pursue for PhD after doing your M.Tech from IIT and IIT. You can pursue PhD from foreign also, we will see. After M.Tech placement, generally, if for campus placement, these are the list of the companies, around 10 to 12 companies visit. Out of them, these are the like Tata, Jindal, Applied Materials, Titan, TVS Motors. These are the major companies. They generally visit IITs and IITs campus for placement. And if you want to go in academic line, you can go for PhD. If you want to go for PhD, I have already told for India. If you want to go for PhD from foreign, there are the several scholarships like DART, Marie Curie Fellowship, and Raman Arpak Fellowship, so that you can apply and got avail the fellowship while PhD. After that, you can directly go for industry job like in research and development, and as well as you can apply for academic assistant professorship, which is now very mandatory. PhD is very mandatory from 2013 for being an assistant professor. And after that, if you want more research experience, you can pursue postdoctorate from India as well as from outside as well. So these are the things. After that, many student questions that what exactly means institute in India where we can do MS. In earlier, United States and Europe were more popular, but currently you can pursue these in India also, like in IIT Kanpur and IIT Madras, and in IISc Bangalore also. And after that, also you can go for PhD and postdoctorate and industrial jobs, accordingly same as we discussed for the M.Tech. And for more placed job, you can visit our LinkedIn page. And if you have more query, you can comment us, and you can drop a mail on our website on studymeta.com. And thank you for listening. Have a nice day. All the best.